to Stanford School of Business lecturer Dave Dodson. Professor, very good to have you. Is it your sense that we get a trade deal, it helps the farmers, or we get a trade deal and it's too late to help the farmers because China could be in a world of hurt? What do you think?
Well, I think the problem that we've got here is we're going to end up with a trade deal, and we're going to end up with a trade deal soon. I mean, we have a political imperative from the Trump administration that we get a win. So that's going to happen. But when it happens, it's going to be like having a house that's crumbling from the inside, and you think, well, I'm going to fix it with a can of paint. No, both sides are going to claim political victory when this trade deal gets done. But what's going to happen is that we will not have addressed the fundamental problem, which is that China has stuff we want to buy, namely computers, smartphones. And what are we selling China? We're selling to China soybeans. And that's our problem. They have things that we want to buy, and we don't have things that they want to buy from us.
But hadn't they committed themselves, Professor, and I know word is everything, and making good on it is another, to buy more of our cars, to buy more of our manufacturing items? Or is that just an empty promise?
We buy $150 billion worth of just computers and smartphones from China. They buy $17 billion of planes and $12 billion of cars. So if we quintupled the number of airplanes and cars that we sold to them, it wouldn't make a dent in our trade deficit. Our problem with our trade deficit is while other countries have paid attention to their long-term economic prospects, we have neglected our long-term economic prospects for the last 20 years. And that's the fundamental problem. And so we're selling them soybeans. Think about that, Neil. We're the agrarian society here. We're selling them soybeans and wheat, and they're selling us computer products.
You know, I never looked at it that way. I'm going to copy everything you said, Professor, and take it as my own comments, just so you know. But could I ask you something? When you step back from this, we both need each other. That's fairly clear. But I'm almost getting the sense that we need the Chinese then more than they need us. Or am I misinterpreting that?
No, I think you're right on. And in fact, this is a trade war that we're losing. And that's what we need to make sure that we're attentive to. We thought, well, let's slap some tariffs on China. They'll come down to their knees and they'll beg us for a trade agreement. But what they did is they turned around and put tariffs on us. And when you have a trade deficit, they can hurt you more than you can hurt them. That's exactly what they did. And the evidence is clear. In the last 6 months, our trade deficit has widened. It hasn't narrowed during this trade war.
That's
so things have gotten worse for us. Meanwhile, look at the hand that we're holding right now. We're in a government shutdown. We've got the Mueller investigation coming on. Michael Cohen's going to be testifying in a few weeks. Now, if you're China, aren't you thinking that the Trump administration really wants a win right now? And so I am afraid that we're going to rush into a trade agreement that doesn't really adequately protect our technology, doesn't really adequately protect our currency trade, because the Trump administration desperately wants an agreement. And indeed, if we get an agreement, it will stabilize the markets. But it's going to stabilize the markets not because we fixed our underlying trade deficit with China. It's going to stabilize the market because we've ended the chaos. And meanwhile, we're going to have an agreement that no one has read. Our senators won't read it. And we're all going to claim victory for something that no one's even going to read.
Let me ask you, as the president has just landed in New Orleans, Professor, he's going to address farmers hurt by the shutdown and everything else. So do you think that part of the Chinese thinking is, wait him out, we don't see this guy getting reelected anyway?
I have no way to know what's going on inside the head of the Chinese negotiators, but I look at it looking down upon the parties. I think that China can be patient, and China doesn't have the political pressure that the Trump administration has right now. And that's what I worry about. I worry about the desire to get a win is going to force us into making some concessions that we shouldn't be making right now.
That's very interesting. Thank you very, very much, sir. Very good talking to you. Dave Dodson, the Stanford School of Business lecturer.